South Africa declares a state of disaster amid the country's worst energy crisis in years. Breakdowns in the grid have forced the country to practice load shedding, which leaves businesses and households in the dark for up to 12 hours a day. The government aims to accelerate the construction of energy projects and purchase excess power from private generators to resolve the crisis. South Korea will resume issuing short-term visas for travelers from China Saturday. Seoul suspended the issue last month as part of stricter border measures due to China's mass COVID outbreak. Beijing retaliated by also halting short-term visas for South Korean travelers. A South Korean official says the government is open to fully resuming visa issuances with a lower number of reported infections among Chinese arrivals. Former U.S. Vice President Mike Pence has been subpoenaed by the special counsel investigating Trump and his role in the January 6th assault on the U.S. Capitol. The subpoena follows months of negotiations between federal prosecutors and Pence's legal team. Pence's testimony could help shed light on Trump's bid to block the certification of Congress of Joe Biden's election victory. Pence had denounced Trump's actions on January 6th as reckless, but declined to answer questions from a congressional committee investigating the Capitol attack. Jack Smith, who is overseeing federal probes into Trump's role in the riot, as well as his handling of classified documents, will determine whether Trump should face any charges. Former U.S. President Donald Trump officially back on Facebook and Instagram. Meta Platforms restored his accounts Thursday following a two-year ban due to the 2021 deadly Capitol Hill riot. Meta announced in January it was restoring Trump's access to his social media sites, adding he may be removed again if he breaks the rules. Trump's Twitter account was reinstated in November, but he has yet to make an official return to the platform. French President Emmanuel Macron not ruling out sending fighter jets to Ukraine. He made the remarks at the sidelines of the European Union summit in Brussels, which Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky attended on Thursday. Macron says the current priority is to send more firepower to Ukraine at the soonest possible time. He explains jets could take a long time to be delivered and would also take time for the training of Ukrainian pilots. Zelensky had been asking Western allies to send the fighter jets to help his country fend off Russian attacks. We begin in Ukraine, where fresh Russian strikes hit two major areas Friday. The attacks are said to have targeted energy facilities in Zaporizhia, where Europe's largest nuclear power plant is located. Officials say the city was hit 17 times in an hour, the most intense period of attacks since the start of the war. Also struck by Russia was Kharkiv, where the city mayor says power and water supply may be disrupted due to damaged critical infrastructure. No word yet on casualties from the attacks. The Philippines and Japan signed 35 letters of intent on investment pledges, seen to create more jobs for Filipinos. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. witnessed the signing of the documents during day three of his official working visit to Japan. The investment commitments with the Japanese government and companies cover industries like infrastructure, energy, health care, and agriculture.
I once again will thank you for considering the Philippines as a place and as a partner to grow your businesses. The government of the Philippines has been working to deepen the confidence in the Philippines of foreign investors and companies.
Marcos assures Japanese companies the Philippine government will continue pursuing efforts to make the country an ideal investment destination.
We have been advancing vital and game-changing reforms to improve the country's business environment. And it is our hope that companies such as yours will not only find the Philippines to be an attractive investment destination. We are designing our efforts to encourage you to stay and to find our country to be a place where your businesses will thrive. We capitalize on economic liberalization laws and strategic reforms to attract companies like yours and facilitate ease of doing business.